สวัสดีค่ะ My name is Teeyapar. Many people call me Eco Angel of Thailand. As you may know that our world is facing with waste management problems, especially plastic waste. Do you know that we generate plastic 400 million tons per year and create plastic waste more than 11 million tons and is trained to increase every year? More importantly, the plastic waste spent more than 400 years on decomposing. That is too massively long time. So I guess that we and all world cannot wait for 400 years. And now we should solve this problem as fast as possible. That made me create my second project. We just call it Waste to Be Well. Waste to Be Well is the project which to reduce plastic waste pollution. We are recycling them and adding values of the plastic waste by upcycling process using our creativity and four easy steps. First, and the most important step for my both projects is a proper waste separation. And this step can easily do it in yourself at home and send them to my company. Then the plastic waste used in this project, while the auto will be used in my first project too. Secondly, clean up plastic waste. Next, melt the plastic. Melt and dry the plastic to be polyester fiber. After that, the plastic fiber will be formed into plastic threads. Finally, send the plastic threads to the texture factory and cutting into uniform, t-shirts, sportwear, and swimwear. And in the future, I want to promote to people around the world use and wear clothing from plastic recycle too. So I think my project is save our spending time on removing plastic waste from 400 years to be a few days. But this is need our little effort to work together in two steps, which are waste separation step and clean the plastic bottle before throw. Only this can reduce amount of plastic waste and adding value of itself. Thought my second project, Waste to Be Well. Therefore, everything is precious as long as we think and reuse it wastefully. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the Sash Factor Live Chat Series for our coverage of Miss Earth 2020. My name is Noy Sabilano. I am your correspondent and your host for tonight. To all of our Thai fans, thank you so much for tuning in. And to all of our international fans, thank you so much for tuning in to our extra special interview with one of the most talked about candidates for Miss Earth 2020. So to all of the fans, I already see a lot of the comments coming in. Please continue keying in all of your comments for our extra special guest, because right now we are going to introduce her. Without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, our eco angel from Thailand, Miss Earth Thailand 2020, Namphech Teeyapar.
My name is Namphech Teeyapar, Eco Angel of Thailand!
Wow! Ladies and gentlemen, the energetic Miss Earth Thailand 2020, Namphech Teeyapar, and her equally energetic team. Can I hear once again the team to clap once again for Namphech right here for our guest interview? There you go. Namphech, thank you so much for guesting once again. This is our second time to talk here on Sash Factor Live Chat. The first time you were kind of busy, right? You were like doing your advocacy, but right now we are on a sit-down interview. We are so happy to have you back. First, we'd like to ask, how are you right now?
I'm so happy right now. I would like to say thank you, Sash Factors. Thank you, all the Filipino fans or Thai fans, and everyone sponsor for make this pageant happen or in 2020. This is like new normal pageant. Thank you, Sash Factors, for always supporting, and thank you to having me again.
Thank you so much, Nampet. Of course, it's our pleasure to have you always back here on Sash Factor. It's going to be a very fun conversation. We can't wait to start this one. But before we begin, because we have a lot, as in a lot of your fans already tuning in, allow me to read some of them right now. The first commenter, maybe you can already say hi to Jake Sopanat Chakyo. Maybe you can say hi to him right now.
Hi, Jake Stopana. Thailand. Yeah, Thailand for the crowd.
There you go. And also here we have... I love how your team is just so energetic as well, Nampech. Good job to them. We have
And also my team is like, oh my God, so energetic.
Yes, and we can see that.
Yeah, and you will see in the final, on the final 29th, November, we have the big event for the coronation night. Yeah, I think we will meet a lot of fans, more than like 200 people. We'll be here at N Street Hotel for watching the big screen and the live for the coronation night of this 2020.
Yes, there you go. Maybe I'm going to like read a couple more. We have your Filipino fan. Starla Abalayan would like to say she is my favorite since 2019. Where is that? Starla Abalayan. I love her since 2019. You can say hi to Starla Abalayan.
Hi, Abalayan. Thank you so much for supporting me. Thank you so much for loving me.
There you go. And I think one of your team members, C-Game is right there, but he's already commenting on the maybe we can flash C-Game's comment. Okay, since he already took the effort to like comment, maybe we can already see his comment. C-Game would like to say hi to you. As if he's not there, right? Okay, and one... Okay, yes.
I said in Thai for our Thai supporter to share this video to give her a support. So it's very honored to be here as well.
Correct. And I think a lot of the fans are also watching because not only of Nampech but also of C-Game, right, Nampech? There. And one last. We have here one of your sisters from 2019, Sarah Langved, who's watching right now.
Sarah! Oh my God, my love, so much. How are you? Hi, love. You are doing great. I'm looking for you from Denmark. I love your dress. I will send to you, Beth. It's my roommate from last year. We stay together like 1.5 months, and we are more than friends, more than the candidates, more than everything. We like a sister like family.
Yes.
She will come to meet me in Thailand also.
Wow, that sounds exciting. So, Sarah, once again, thank you for watching. And to all of the fans, please continue keying in your comments because right now, we're going to talk about a lot of things because Nampech, we all know that it's only, I think, more than a week from now before we crown officially Miss Earth 2020. But then, a while ago, you already competed in one of the most exciting competitions in the Miss Earth pageant, which is the National Costume Competition. Actually, I'd like to talk about that. But before that, allow us to play a video that talks about your heritage, your identity as Thai and as an Igbo Asian from Thailand. Let's all watch this video right now. So this was your national costume ng Pech. So incredibly creative. Maybe you can tell us a little bit about that national costume. What was that costume all about?
Okay, so national costume, my national costume name is Suwarna Macha. It's the angel of the ocean. It's like the god of the ocean who protect the marine life, the natural in underwater. Protect all the Malay life to be safe and peaceful, something like that. Maybe for a national costume, I think my translator will.
Sure, I'll be doing the honor. So like she mentioned, that her national costume is called Suwarna Macha, Angel of the Sea. Well, Suwarna Macha, Angel of the Sea is inspired by a character in Thai ancient literature called Ramakien, derived from the well-known Sanskrit epic called Ramayana. The Suwarna Macha is a goddess and a protector of the ocean, nature and all marine life in Namphet's interpretation. And also that she wants to protect and help marine life and the ocean to be safe and clean. Well, the design comprises of 5 elaborate patterns defining the uniqueness and identity of Thailand. Well, Suwarna means gold and it's relevant to her last name as well, which means go as well. The designer is Mr. Desha Swaby from Star Inside Studio.
Wow.
More important, not the Yatsala or jewelry. They come to join my national video. It make my national costume video is feel like I have a life. I have real life in my national costume. When I saw the music and I saw the fish, it's like I feel like seeing I have a power to protect the ocean, something like that.
Yes. Actually, Nampech, I watched the performance during the national costume competition. I love, aside from the fact that the costume was so creative, it was so beautiful, your performance was also really outstanding. So congratulations to you and your team. One of my favorites thus far for Asian Oceania a while ago. So congratulations to the entire team. Of course, you're welcome. Now, we're going to talk about, aside from the national costume, we want to know Nampech a little bit more on a personal level this time. Okay, so we have prepared a lot of new segments for this extra special interview with Nampech, where we're going to start off with the very light ones. Okay, we want to call the first segment as Simply Nampech.
Bring it on.
Very good. Simply Nampech, because we want to know a little bit more about you on a personal level, the things that you like, the things you like to do, by asking you very simple questions. Okay, are you ready to answer the first question?
Okay, great.
There you go. First question is, one thing people do not know about me is blank. One thing people do not know about me is?
One thing that people doesn't know about me because I am there's a lot of things that people don't know about me, but the one thing the people judging me is like I am look not also love and care the environment, but actually I doing very very big project and I understand about the environment problem like really deeply. This is the one thing that people don't know about me.
Wow, there you go. And I think we're going to talk more about a lot of your projects in a little bit. Thank you for sharing that, Nambetch. Next one. My favorite vacation spot in the world is? So where is your favorite vacation spot? It could be in Thailand or anywhere in the world.
Oh my God. I cannot say that. I cannot list my favorite spot because I love vacation so much. And every place I go is a lot of favorite sport, and because they are so beautiful and have magic power. Like I love Philippines because I love the ocean. I love the natural. I love to see the shark wow. I love to learn about the animal life. I love Japan. I love Thailand. I love Maldives. I love Bahamas. I love New York. I love everywhere in the world. Yeah, so, I don't know what is my favorite sport because, you know, when you do vacation, traveling, you got a lot of experience. And you see how the beautiful world are, like different earth, different sky, different culture, different people. That's beautiful.
Yes, yes. And it's really great to know that you are a really wide traveler because as a Miss Earth candidate, it means that you have a lot of like experience with different cultures, which makes you a really good candidate for the crown. So good job for you for that one, Nambetch. Next one. This one is kind of very interesting. My favorite food to eat when I'm stressed is? So when you're so tired, when you are so stressed, what is that one food that you eat?
Of course, any food is sweet because when you're tired, your body needs sugar. Any chocolate, dessert, or sweet word. It's like I'm commenting from tweeting or when I'm reading on Facebook, this is I eat when I'm tired and stressed. Thank you.
Yes, same thing here. When I'm tired, I just eat. No matter what happens, I like to eat.
If you follow my Instagram or Facebook, you guys will see I am Miss Eat 2020 because I eat a lot of things in buffet, everything. And also when I'm going to Philippines, I love to eat the Philippine mango. It's like, the taste is like yummy and I eat a lot. I eat maybe 10, 11 for one time.
Yes. I cannot blame you because the Philippine mango is the sweetest and most delicious in the world. We're so proud of that. So, yes. Yes, there you go. Next one. Next one, Nambetch. This one is, what is the first thing that you do when you are super happy? First thing that I do when I'm super happy?
Eat again. Eat again, I'm happy. Because even you're tired, unhappy, or you're happy, if you eat, when you eat, when you're happy, it's more happy.
Yeah, I agree with that. So it's all about food that makes you happy. So we get that. Thank you for sharing that message. Next one. This one, of course, from happy to angry. When was the last time you got really upset and really angry? Can you remember the last time you were so upset and so angry?
The last time when I'm the person who never angry for anything like easy, but I'm a little bit upset about myself or something like how to say when people talking about bad things and like they're judging me but I'm not like that like I'm just making me a little sad.
Yeah. Of course, yes. And actually, we can see it. I think you are someone who doesn't really hold it too much, like too much anger in your heart. That's why you are so beautiful all the time, right?
Yes, without anger, positive, think happy all the time. But I think maybe 90% in your life better, because like you cannot happy all the time. Sometimes you have like to be your own self. Like you are in the room, you can't accept for anything. You can do it like negative thing, but maybe 10% in your life is make like, you know, smooth. Like, make your life complete. Have to be yin and yang.
Yeah, that's actually really great that you shared that. Of course, we can't be happy all the time. We just have to be, you know, just deal with life as it is, right? Now, speaking of like happiness, since you mentioned that happiness is the key to like a happy heart as well. When was the last time, or I feel at my most beautiful when? When do you feel you are at your most beautiful?
When I feel the most beautiful. Every time I look at the mirror, I feel I'm proud of myself. I feel I'm beautiful when I look at the mirror, like every time.
Wow.
Because you have to respect yourself, right? You have to respect yourself, how beautiful you are. And then like, whatever other people say about you are not beautiful, but inside you have to respect yourself. I am beautiful. It make you happy and like have strong mindset and stay positive.
Yes, I totally agree with that. I love what you said, that you feel beautiful and you have to feel beautiful all the time, no matter what happens, no matter what other people say about you. That's really a great message. And one last message. This one is actually in connection with the last answer you had. Since you are a woman of the earth, can you tell me what is that one word to describe you as a woman? One word to describe you as a woman.
Just one word, right?
Yeah, just one word.
Wonderful.
Why wonderful? Why that's a really great word. Why wonderful?
Why wonderful? I think like, you know, when people say something about you, like, how is the pet? She's wonderful woman. This means you have a lot of things for special, right? Example, like you, Pet is wonderful because she's like doing project on your advocacy. She is real queen, real action. She have real project or beautiful. Like Nam Pet, she's like never scared, but she's happy all the time. She's make me happy too. That's wonderful. Like.
You know, that's a really great word, and that's also an inspiring word, that it's also something that people can learn about you as a woman, and they can actually follow you. Just feel wonderful, just be kind, and just be happy, just the way you are, right? I mean, that's the message that we want to convey to people. So thank you so much, Nampech, and that wraps up the first segment. Thank you so much, Nampech, for letting us in into your life by answering those questions. Now, allow me to read. There are a lot of comments already. We are flooded by comments already. One here is actually a familiar name. Actually, my fellow, my co-host on MEC on Miss Earth Crown, Emmanuel Feliciano, is watching right now. Hi, Emma. Thank you for being from Japan.
Hi.
Yes. And I must say that was also a really great interview. I was so happy that I watched it as well. Too bad I wasn't part of it. But of course, right now we're doing this interview, so I'm so happy. One more. We have here Aidan Crew. Aidan Crew would like to say, beautiful with the purpose. I should agree, Aidan Crew, beautiful with the purpose. Thank you so much, Aidan, for watching us right now. Maybe a couple more. There are a lot of comments here right now. We have here, this one's really great. Dylan Wayne would like to say that she's deserving to be Miss Earth. What can I say about that, Nampech?
Thank you so much. I'm so honorable.
Crown already. And one last here, one of your fellow Thai, Arunrung Pukdi. Arunrung Pukdi would like to say, you will bring the crown back home. Thank you so much, Arumrum, for saying that to our dear Numpetch. Congratulations.
I'm ready, but this is my question. If like we win the crown, how do we win the crown right now? It will be virtual, right?
Well, that's actually one of the questions we also ask right now. How are we going to do that? That's a really good question. To anyone from Miss Earth, how is she going to wear the crown if she wins it? Are you going to send it?
The egg or my Thai pose or Philippine pose?
Yes, exactly. Okay. Yeah, so again,
you know, when this has become the virtual competition, all the people in Thailand ask me, like, if who win the crown, how she will take a crown?
Maybe a filter from Instagram as well. So we do not know. We will have to wait. Okay, there you go. To all of the fans, thank you so much. We're going to read more of your questions and your shout outs. But right now, I'd like to talk to Numpetch about more serious issues. Of course, Numpetch, you were one of the most talked about candidates in this year's edition for many reasons, right? Now, I'd like to talk about your candidacy to Miss Earth 2020. Now, Numpetch as a public figure, okay? Let's now talk about Numpetch as a public figure, as a pageant celebrity, by asking you some Sash Factor real talk pageant questions, okay? So are you ready to answer our pageant real talk questions? There you go. Okay, first question, Numpetch. Real talk question number one. I'd like you to answer this. Do you feel there is more love or more hate now for you as a candidate in Miss Earth 2020? What do you feel? Do you feel there is more love or more hate now for you as a candidate in Miss Earth 2020?
I feel the people sending me love more than last year because, you know what? Because this year I'm very, very contribute myself to win the pageant for this year. I am so intelligent I want to make something better for the environment in my country and all the world also. That's why all the people see how I contribute myself to be Miss Earth, and they are like sending me love because they want me to win also. When I'm read at the comment at my Instagram or the social media, I'm so thank you a lot everyone for supporting and rooting for me for win the crown this year. And thank you so much.
Actually, I totally agree with you, Numpetch. I mean, in any pageant, especially with a candidate like you, I mean, we cannot help it, but if there are some who would love you so much and there are some who do not love you, right? And I mean, that's the reality. The only thing that we can do is just, you know, move on and do the very best that we can to win the crown for Thailand. And that's, I think, what you're doing right now. So congratulations, Namkesh. Next one, pageant real talk number two, okay? This one's kind of like a juicy question. Real talk question two, what is your reaction when people say that you're joining again in Miss Earth is unfair, quote-unquote unfair, since you already competed before? What is your reaction to this statement from some fans that it's unfair?
For me, I think it's not true because this year is going to be virtual pageant online. We didn't go to Philippines again. I think it's fair. For me, คืออย่างที่บอกเพชรตั้งใจมากกับการประกวดแล้วเพชรรู้สึกว่าเพชรอยากเป็นมิสเตอร์จริงๆนั่นคือทำไมเพชรถึงพรีเซนต์ทุกโปรเจกต์ที่มันจะช่วยลดปัญหาสิ่งแวดล้อมอย่างเช่นการลด waste พลาสติกเวสต์โซลูชันของเพชรที่เพชรทำอันนี้ก็คือเพชรทำออกมาจริงๆเพื่ออยากที่จะให้ทั่วโลกตระหนักถึงปัญหาแล้วก็ได้มีมิสเอิร์ธที่เราสามารถทำโปรเจกต์ขึ้นมาจริงๆไม่ใช่แค่เป็นมิสเอิร์ธแต่ว่ามันตอบคำถามได้ดีอย่างเดียวตอบคำถามบนเวทีได้อย่างเดียวแต่ว่าเรียลแอคชั่นไม่มีอันนี้ค่ะเพชรมีความรู้สึกว่าเพชรตั้งใจแล้วก็อยากให้ทุกคนโฟกัสกับความตั้งใจของเพชรที่อยากที่จะทำสิ่งที่ดีให้กับสิ่งแวดล้อมในไม่ใช่แค่ในประเทศไทยแต่ว่าเพชรรู้สึกว่าเพชรอยากจะทำให้ทั้งโลกมันดีขึ้นแล้วก็ลดปัญหาสิ่งแวดล้อมจากขยะพลาสติกจริงๆแล้วเพชรเชื่อว่าเพชรทำได้อยากให้ทุกคนให้กำลังใจแล้วก็ซัพพอร์ตเพชรตรงนี้มากกว่าค่ะ
Well I feel extremely focused as I rejoined the pageant this year because I've put so much and effort at Miss Earth Thailand 2020.And it is because that I would like to continue my project on the reducing of the plastic waste. And also I would like to make the world realize that the real beauty queen, the real Miss Earth, should be someone who is not just only good in answering questions on the stage, but look what I've done. I've done so much, I contributed so much, and also I keep doing and going on my advocacies.So I want to make the world realized, and when I become Miss Earth 2020, I would have a loud voice, and I would be the voice of the environment. And I truly believe that I can convey the people and also will help the world to be a better place to be.
Thank you.
Yeah, actually, it's a really great answer. I mean, more than anything else, more than like competing for the crown, Nampesh, I think what's important is that you are.A symbol for women who do not want to give up because they want to achieve something in life and they want to pursue something in life and continue doing good for the environment, right? I think that's also the message.
For me, I'm for the last year, I have already give up myself. I don't want to doing pageant anymore in my life.Because I've done a lot of beauty pageants for 7 years. I'm joined 7 international beauty pageants. But after I'm joined Miss Earth is give me a lot of experience and, you know, about the learning how to take care of the environment. I am so deep in Miss Earth's side. That's why I'm thinking I want to change a lot of the environment problems. Like,I see a lot of problems about the waste, like the rotten waste, the plastic waste, the infection waste. And for me, now it's 2020. The queen or like the real queen is not just like, you don't just want the beauty, you don't just want the beauty and answer the waiting questions. But now the queen has to real help for the environment. And I believe in my condition, my company, because Now I'm working the companies about a safe environment. We're doing some solving the rotten food waste from the household to be organic fertilizer for solving the rotten food waste. And also plastic waste, I showed you last year. I am starting with very, very small project. I have just one round, like a green side, and show the top judges. And I'm continue for a year to make it bigger.Like in the future, I really want to promote about my project to people around the world to changing your personal clothes to use in recycled material, recycled plastic in the world. This is a truly to reduce the overflowing plastic problem right now because we cannot wait for it decomposing for 400 years. But now I have real technology to.Reducing it, and for me, I can work really, really smoothly with this organization because I love the environment. I love Miss Earth. Yeah, this is my heart. Want to speak with you guys. I really want you to support.
Yes, and I think you mentioned before that this is going to be your very last year competing for a pageant, right?
Yes.
And I think, yes. Right? And maybe last year, if it's your last year, I think. you will have to choose a pageant that you are so passionate about. And I think you've chosen the perfect pageant for you, right? Yeah.
Okay. So, yes, this is my last pageant. And I want to join the pageant the way I love to join, because I love the environment. That's why I should miss it again. But actually, I have a lot of pageants want me to join, like Miss Universe Thailand or Miss International Thailand. Like, they asking me to join again, or Miss Globe, Miss Global. They still asking me to join them. For me, it's like, I'm thinking what I want in my life. And after that, my answer is like, I want to join Miss Earth again. And
เราไม่สนใจว่ามันจะรู้สึกว่าเราจะชนะการประกวดนี้หรือไม่แต่สุดท้ายแล้วอ่ะที่ทำเต็มที่เราจะได้โชว์ทุกอย่างที่ใจที่อยากจะทำให้เต็มที่ในครั้งสุดท้ายชีวิตแล้วอันนี้พี่พอใจแล้ว
alright so it doesn't matter which pageant are you joining and you know even winning the crown it's not really a big deal compared to what I really wanted to do is to be the contestant of the Miss Earth 2020 and rejoin again, continue my project, and also I'll do my best, give my best, and then the result, whatever result may be. So I also accept, and also that's the part of the experience that we gain to make me grow.
There you go. Thank you so much, Nampet, for sharing why you really pushed for Miss Earth for the very last time this year. And we totally understand, we totally agree with your mission. Now, real talk question number three, Nampet, okay? Of course, your return to Miss Earth went with a lot of controversy, especially from the fans. I think you are so aware of this. Real talk question number three, Nampet. You have been called hurtful words online, right? Plastic queen, so older, a lot of different things. My question for you right now is, how do you deal with all of the bashing? How do you deal with all of the negative comments and words from some of the fans who do not like that are here on this Earth 2020?
Okay. Yes. So, I think for me, I have to clear my brain before you answer the dispatcher or managing with the dispatcher in social media. This is like social bullying. You have to respect yourself. What are you doing? Who you are? And love yourself enough to be star. And Like I say, you have to respect yourself and answer them like you are strong. You are strong enough, or you good enough to stay in the world, because we cannot stop the people who are bullying you, whatever you are, but you are doing great. I'm doing good. I represent my country. I'm doing for myself, for the environment, for society. Have a lot of things I'm doing and bigger. For me, if you're strong enough, you will pass this. You don't need to you root back for the comments, but you just be yourself and you be strong. Just answer that comment nicely. That is my answer.
And that's the management. I will have to manage my feeling myself mainly instead of managing with those negative words. Thank you.
Thank you.
You're muted.
That is a really great message, Nampech, about your experience. And I think a lot of people will learn a lot from your experience in like online bashing, online bullying, which leads me to our last real talk question, okay? I'd like to ask you, Nampech, since you are given a platform to talk to millions of fans worldwide, what do you think is the greatest lesson that all of us can learn from your experience in dealing with all of the negativity online. What is that one greatest lesson?
Okay. So when you reading a lot of negativity, is deep your life, deep yourself down, and maybe you cannot fight for it, you will feel weak for it. But for me, I give it to be my powerful to make my rise goes up and success and success and success again. พูดไม่ดีกับเราดูถูกเหยียดหยามเราหรือจะด่าทอเราด้วยคำหยาบๆคล้ายๆขนาดไหนแต่อย่างที่เป็นบอกไปค่ะคุณต้องรักตัวเองให้มากพอแล้วคุณก็ต้องเชื่อมั่นในตัวเองว่าคุณมีดีฉันมีค่าและฉันทำได้ฉันแกร่งพอที่จะต่อสู้กับความเนกาทีฟทั้งหมดแล้วก็เก็บมันเป็นพลังที่ทรงคุณค่ามันจะเหมือนกับสปริงนะคะที่พอสปริงที่มันโดนกดทับมากๆแล้วเนี่ยเวลาที่มันดีดขึ้นไปอ่ะมันจะดีดได้ไกลและสูงที่สุดอันนี้ค่ะเพชรก็อยากเป็นกำลังใจให้ทุกคนเหมือนกันเนี่ยถ้าเกิดว่าคุณโดนเหยียดหยามด้วยคำพูดหรือทำอะไรก็ตามที่เป็นเชิงเนกาทีฟทำให้คุณรู้สึกดาวคุณต้องคิดว่าตัวเองเป็นสปริงค่ะดีดมันให้เป็นพลังและทำให้ชีวิตคุณสำเร็จและสักเซสขึ้น
Well, it doesn't matter what people would say to you, would insult you, or would give you bad words or badging you in which way. What you have to do and what I have learned is that to love yourself, to love myself, and believe in myself that I can do and I accomplished anything if I intend to do. I'm strong enough, and you have to turn those negative words and compare those negative words like a spring.Like, not a spring, the season, but a spring that is, that when it's like crushed hard, and then, you know, like you have to bounce back, you know, like those words, are the spring that even like the harder the crush and the bouncing back would be very powerful. So, I like to give my support to, fans and also those whofollow me as well when you're facing a hard situation and also if anyone would say something bad to you and then you turn those bad words into a power and will accomplish something in your life to show them by your action, not saying something negatively back to them.
And more important, you have to smile all the negative
Yeah, such a really great message. You know, Nampech, one thing I learned about your, how you deal with bashers and the fans who cannot say anything good about you, it's all about being graceful and being respectful. And one last is filling them with kindness and love all the time. I mean, we just have to like fill with your heart with a lot of love and a lot of kindness because you know in your heart that you are,a really great person, and that's all that matters for all of the fans who love you and adore you, no matter what happens. So congratulations, Nampech, for that. Now, since you already mentioned about being strong and being a passionate woman, I'd like to move on now to the next part of our interview. Since you mentioned that you have learned to become a really strong and incredible woman of the earth, I'd like you to have an opportunity to talk about the women in your life, like some of your friends, some of the women who have supported you and made you to the person that you are right now. We are calling this segment Queen to Queen, okay? This is a very special new segment on Sash Factor, Queen to Queen. What we're going to do is, of course, we're not only going to talk about Miss Earth, Nampech.We're also going to talk about your sisters in the world of pageantry outside Miss Earth. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to show Nampech some photos of her queen sisters and other queen supporters. And she has to tell us a story or two about that queen that we're going to show. So Nampech, let's have our first photo queen to queen, what can you say about the first queen is, of course, the Miss Universe Thailand 2020. Amanda
Lovely. She is from South Thailand, where we know each other for many years. I really want to support her to do your best in Miss Universe. So congratulations again, because now she is so busy on she activity on Miss Universe. And so grateful to be you in Thailand team for 2020. We will make our country so proud.
Yes. Actually, Nampech, with the addition of Amanda, you're right. I think Team Thailand for 2020 is so strong this year. So congratulations also to Amanda. And of course, with you for Miss Earth 2020. Now, one follow-up question about Amanda. Is there any fun or like interesting experience with Amanda that you'd like to share with us? Like a fun fact, as friends? Do you have anything to share?
When Miss Universe Thailand, I'm going to the congratulation her on an after party, and I give her okay, thank you.
On the after party night, after that she won the title as Miss Thailand, Miss Universe Thailand 2020, there was the after party, and I went there and I gave her the Buddha amulets for her to, and then she said like, thank you very much, and this is like my lucky charm, and also that I bring you luck and also happiness in your life. And she said, thank you.
Oh, actually it's a really great story that you mentioned. Thank you so much. It just goes to show that queens in Thailand are very supportive of each other. Right, you support one another. That's very apparent.
Exactly.
Which leads me to our second queen. Okay, our second queen here is a familiar face to all of the Miss Earth fans. Our second queen is, of course, Punica Polly.
Oh my God!
So,
fairy tale.
What is one story? Yes, one story that you have about Punica that you'd like to share to everyone.
Punica, she is very, very gorgeous girl. When she going to somewhere with me, she's always cute me with her beautiful face and her work and oh my God. And now I'm so very, very glad for her because she success on Miss Universe Thailand. She feel like a newborn of her, and she's very good person. She's very good people. The one time when they have COVID-19 pandemic, I invite her to join my event for giving the food and stuff for the help people. She never say no. She's always come and say yes, and she's a very good heart and very good people. Thank you. I love you, Punica.
Oh, and actually, Nambesh, I think like you, Punica is also one of the most loved Miss Earth Thailand ever. I mean, she's so much loved by especially the Filipino fans. Am I right? There are a lot of her Filipino fans.
Yes. She has a lot of Filipino fans, and I think she has a lot of fans in the world.
Yes, right? correct. And also someone who never gives up in her dreams, right? There you go, Punica, just like you. Next one. This one is very familiar with you. Of course, our reigning queen, Nelis Pimentel, Miss Earth 2019. What can you say about her? Queen to queen, any special story about Nelis?
Hi, sister. I will see you again on Miss Earth 2020, and you will be give your crown to me and the next Miss Earth. And I missed you so much. There's a lot of experience and we have a good time together in 2019. I hope you stay safe and we will meet again after coronation night, you will give me a crown. Thank you, Millie. And I am ready to take your crown to the next week.
Yes. So once again, Melis, if you're watching, Nampech wants your crown right now. Give it for her. It's your friend. Am I right, Nampech?
Yes, your friend, Nelly.
There you go.
When the coronation night on 2019, when I didn't go to the top 10, and I was backstage and say, Puerto Rico, Puerto Rico, and then she was woo!
Wow!
Yes.
That's actually a really great story that you were cheering for Puerto Rico during that night. There you go. Now, one last Nampech, about your queen sisters last year, aside from, of course, Sarah that you mentioned a while ago, if you're going to have like one meet up with one or two of your sisters from last year that you miss so much, who would they be and why? Like, the ones that you miss so much from last year.
Of course, there are. and our Asian Oceanic group, fire group. I miss all my sister fire group. Fire is the power. And of course, Sarah, because it's a lot of time we happy together, we step together, we help each other. We spend a lot of like the most beautiful memorable times together is not just Sarah, but our sister from fire group, Mr. 2019. I am very, very miss all of them. And if you have a chance, I would like to invite everyone to reunion fire group again in Thailand because my house and my hotels also, and yeah, we will have a great time together. The one time if we have a reunion for real, we will invite all of you also. Just buy your ticket because when you come to stay, you have an entry hotel in Bangkok, you have Kalimai from Phuket, you have Kalimai Kalak also for take care of you. Yeah. And also, I'm planning about this year, about Asia and Oceania group. We will have reunion after the pandemic also.
Wow, that sounds exciting. So Fire Group and Asian Oceania this year is going to have a reunion. So we can't wait for that. Nampech, thank you for that. Second to the last, queen to queen, of course, our Mother Earth, our Queen Mother. What can you say about the co-founder of Miss Earth, Lorraine Shook? We have the photo there of Miss Lorraine Shook, co-founder of Miss Earth. What can you say about Miss Lorraine? Any special experience with Miss Lorraine?
Hi, Mom. Mabuhay. I miss you so much. And today, thank you for having me on Miss Earth 2020 again. Thank you for giving me a second chance for do a lot of good things for the environment. I love Miss Earth organization so much, and I would like to work with Miss organization for the new plastic waste, my project and everything. So, when I was young, I really want to have to make something great for the environment. For now, it's my dream come true to represent Thailand on Miss Earth, and also I'm so thank you a lot of experience of Miss Earth organization give me, and I gain a lot of experience and knowledge how to take care of environment. And when I come back, I'm still keeping touch and really want to go back to Miss Earth again. And very, very thank you for everything. Love you.
Yeah. And of course, we also like to say thank you to Miss Lorraine for giving me an opportunity to come back, because if it weren't for Miss Lorraine saying yes to you to come back, you wouldn't have this interview right now. But of course, aside from Madame Lorraine, there was another queen, quote unquote, who gave you this opportunity. Okay? Our last queen to queen is, of course, your national director, Dr. Sirikan, is also here right now. A beautiful photo. Look at that. Dr. Sirikan can be a candidate in 2021. Don't you agree? There you go, Dr. Sirikan. Maybe you can say hi to the fans. There you go. Now, since she's here right now, Numpet, do you have any special message to your national director? I mean, he's been here to take it. What is your special message to her?
First, I have to say thank you for her to shoot me to represent Thailand again. I'm so happy so much because I'm like I said, I'm very want to do something better to fix the problem of environment, and then she shoot me to give me a chance to speak louder to people around the world what I am doing right now. Thank you a chance you support me. Thank you, Ashan, you gave it to me to doing for today. And she's the first time she will be a national director of the big four pageant in the world. She's very doing great. She's like, she stay beside me all the time when I am going to shooting in outside Bangkok, another province. Even I am so very, very hard. I'm so tired. She's away here. She's like the best.
Wow, there you go. Dr. Sirikan, since you're already here, do you have any special message to Numpesh? I mean, how proud are you of Numpesh? How proud are you of your queen right now? Any special message for her?
เป็นคนที่มีเสียงที่ก้องกังวานแล้วก็เข้าใจหัวใจของสิ่งแวดล้อมของโลกใบนี้เขารู้จักประหยัดนะคะทรัพยากรธรรมชาติเขารู้จักที่จะแบ่งปันทุกคนนะคะที่ด้อยโอกาสแล้วก็เขาจะกระตุ้นเตือนทุกคนในการใช้สิ่งที่เกินความจำเป็นนะคะแล้วเขาใช้เสื้อผ้าที่ประดิษฐ์นะคะมาจากรีไซเคิลด้วยนะคะก็ภูมิใจกับลูกสาวคนนี้เขาเป็นคนที่รักทุกคนจริงๆแล้วก็เขารักตัวของเขานะคะเพื่อเป็นตัวอย่างให้กับคนอื่นในการรักและการใช้ชีวิตด้วยกันด้วยความรักค่ะ
Alright, so I feel very proud of my daughter. Not only that she is representative of Miss Earth Thailand 2020, but as a woman.Who has the love of nature, and also she know how to save the earth and the environment effectively, and she also shared this informative information, spreading news and words by her project. Not only that she speak, but also that she does something really, and also that she encourages the people around the world to realize that it's very important.To save the earth. For example, the clothes that she's wearing also made from recycled plastic as well. And she also owned the project of recycled plastic bottle and made it to beautiful fabrics. And also that I feel very proud and she loves everyone. And of course, she loved Mother Earth so much.
Thank you.
Wow, there you go. And of course,Dr. Sirikan, congratulations as well. I think you are going to do an amazing job as a national director of Miss Earth Thailand. We can't wait for the coming years. I think you're going to have a great, great, great job for being the national director. So congratulations. Thank you, ma'am. All right. Now, since Dr. Sirikan Nampes already mentioned, yes.
Even this year it will be virtual online,But I think all the fans will see Thailand team is like, make a competition is seem like real competition. We are making the stage, we are making everything setting for the real competition, real beauty pageant. It's because of her. She's like prepare everything for the place, for the steaming and the team and everything with like, you know, a lot of detail. She's likeThailand is doing so well because of her. So thank you, Mama.
Yay. congratulations as well. Oh, like a really mother-daughter tandem, really, really tender moment. Thank you so much. Now, Nampech, since your mom already mentioned about your advocacy, now is our time to talk about your advocacy, okay, as an eco-angel. But first, Nampech, I'd like to ask you, since the theme, there you go, since the theme of this year, yes, the theme this year is eco-angels of the earth. I'd like to ask you, Nampech, what does the term eco-angel mean to you? The term eco-angel, personally, what does it mean to you?
The meaning of eco-angel for me is
she has to be beautiful and she got to have the love for Mother Earth.
และที่สำคัญนะคะคำว่า eco คือคำว่าประหยัดคือการใช้ทรัพยากรให้เกิดความ eco ไม่ว่าจะเป็น eco friendly แต่ที่สำคัญ eco angel has to be eco mindset.
Alright, and most importantly, as the word eco means that you've got to know how to save and how to manage the resources and use it effectively and well managed of the sources and also the resources. Whether it be water, whether it be air, or whatever that you would get from the nature. So she's the one who knows how to manage them effectively.
So like for me, eco angel, more important, have to be eco mindset. If you have eco mindset, everything you do in your daily life, it will be eco also. It's like my advocacy or the dress or my eco angel suit. The wings of me is from eco-friendly because I make from plastic recycle also. And for me, eco-angel not even have to know deeply about how to be eco, but have to make the real action for the eco in your daily life. This is the real
Yeah, that's a really great meeting, Nampech. I mean, an eco-angel has an eco mindset. And an eco mindset, right, actually does eco efforts and eco action. Right? Wow, really great answer. That's a final answer, right? That's a final question answer already. Congratulations, Nampech. Now, let's talk about let's talk about your advocacies this time. For specifically, of course, you are pushing for the first one. You're doing a lot, actually. I've done my research, you're doing a lot. But the very first one, the one at the forefront is plastic recycling. Now, maybe you can tell us a little bit more. I have the photo here of your outfit, right?
Yes.
And maybe you can talk about plastic recycling as your advocacy as an eco angel to Miss Earth 2020. There you go. Okay, let's see that.
This is the upcycling process. Yes, this is the upcycling process. อันนี้นะคะก็ทำจากขวดพลาสติกนะคะ This is the how to make the clothes from the recycling material จากขวดที่เป็นขวดพลาสติกที่เราทิ้งกันไปนะคะ
From throwing away bottles of plastic
เราจะเอามาบดเป็นชิ้นเล็กๆนะคะเ
พื่อ make into small pieces
ใช่ค่ะเพื่อจะเตรียมที่ทำให้มันเป็นเส้นใยนะคะ
Before we prepare and turn them into the fiber
ใช่ค่ะแล้วหลังจากนั้นนะคะไฟเบอร์เราจะทำให้มันเป็นเส้นได
้ and then we mixed it and also went through the process and made it a thread
แล้วหลังจากนั้นเราก็จะเอามาทำให้เป็นผ้าแบบนี้นะคะเพื่อจะเอามาพิมพ์ลาย
before we weave into the one big fabric and then we print beautiful colors and also beautiful designs to the fabric
yes and also that dress is very very special because I make like my imagination, but like Filipino style, like a little bit copy with Queen Pia, Miss Universe style about on my gown, like a skirt, and a little bit like make it Thai style, and the color is from the moonlight that give me the power of oh my god, it's so imagination. like I do this project because I want people to see the benefit of the recycling and upcycling from plastic bottle, from the plastic waste, because the people who doesn't know, I believe it's someone, they doesn't know when we throw up the plastic and then where we going, right? Because the people, they will not do waste separate in their own house. But now, my project is show about the, if you have the clean plastic waste for don't recycle, we can make a lot of things from recycled plastic.
Yes. Actually, Nam Pesh, I have one more question about that. Since you have formed and created very incredible outfits out of recycled plastic, do you have any plans of like putting up, let's say, for example, a fashion show, like a full glass fashion show of your recycled outfits? What is the ultimate dream for your recycled plastic of and dresses in the future? Are we going to like watch or see some fashion show? Your outfits. What's the plan?
Okay, so in my dream, I want this project. I want my recycled clothes to be heard about around the world. I want all the people in the world using all the fashions. Or fashion industry used from plastic recycled fabric. Like, it's like for now, I'm doing in real, it's not dream. It's like, I'm support and promote to the company, the big company in Thailand, like Isuzu or the Kalima Hotel or the N-Street Hotel or Street Thai Gym. Or any restaurant or the restaurant or the people have company, they have uniform for that, right? I support them to use the uniform from the plastic recycled fabric. It's like if you need something like the touchings feel like the cotton, you can mix polyester fiber from recycled mixed with cotton and then make the clothes from cotton. You can, if you want to do some sportwear or like the clothes from that looks like elastic, you can mix with spandex. Use the polyester fiber from recycle mix with spandex to make that fabric. Like you can create a lot of things from recycled plastic, and it's truly help pollution because we don't need to produce new polymer material for fashion industry. Yes. And the fashion industry really let the carbon to the air, is make a lot of air pollution. But this is my project, I think is so really actively and really well, like very complete for clean the world, clean the plastic waste and also clean the pollution.
Yes, actually, I totally agree because a lot of people do not know that the fashion industry is one of the top contributors of pollution around the world. So that is a very great advocacy. So congratulations for continuing that. I'm so happy that you're continuing that advocacy with
I can do it for real because for now we have big company. We have a very, very big company and factory who transform plastic. You know what, because all the plastic in the world from 100% and now have just 10% can do recycle. Now 90% still in the ocean, still in the earth, still in the everything in the world is make a lot of problem for environment. This is like my goal and my dream to clean it, and we can work it together because if some country in Asia like they want to recycle plastic, you have no how to finish with the plastic in my video. But you have the bottle plastic, right? That's like all the preparing for the make it for the beef. And then like example, you guys can send me the plastic waste by like shipping cargo or something, because I think for the plastic it's not so much cost for sending, you know, it's not like expensive. But and for the transform plastic is very easy, and then we will send the fabric back to your country. Now it's easy.
Wow.
If you don't have cost to make the new factories. And also my advocacy just are more make the plastic recycle cloth. We generate the plastic waste to like three type of plastic waste, like PET plastic. We can do the cloth, fabric, and everything, right? And another thing is the plastic, like a plastic cap, plastic bag. If you clean it, we can make recycle fuel to make like a renewable energy. But like they were selling like 60 or 70% to be biodiesel and 30% benzene. And another plastic, like, can you show me an example about the plastic? Any plastic, anyways.
Yes, like, so we can just
show
some examples
here. There. Even the pieces of this plastic or anything, now in my country, to join my project to be like zero waste system, to transform the plastic waste or any waste into energy, make the electric, the green energy from the waste. And we will not let any carbon, or no. Like, we will not let much carbon to the air, because we use fuel grass proper, they will lose 90% of carbon let to the air, like lost 90%, not just 10% in the air. Now we will, yeah, we the factory will finish in maybe 6 months.
Yes, actually, here in the Philippines, since you already mentioned that you are inviting all of the fans abroad to send you the plastics, here in the Philippines, there are a lot of plastics. So please brace yourself if there are Filipinos who bring the plastics over to Thailand, and if you can change them into like fabric, that would be so awesome. Here in the Philippines, it's so many plastics actually.
Because I think organizations work with Philippine government, right? I think this project is going to be easy. It's like I become the Miss Earth. I am the part of Miss Earth organization, and I will handle all this project to support and promote the Filipino. I believe all the Filipino people, they love our environment. They love environment, and they want to reduce the overflowing plastic waste also. And now Thailand and Philippines are very close together. Why not we join this project and reduce this together?
Yes, exactly. And I think, Tampech, if ever you win the crown for this year, just imagine, to all of our fans, just imagine the kind of work that Tampech is going to do if ever she wins the crown international level for her project. So we cannot wait if ever that's going to happen, Tampech. So congratulations in advance. Now, One more project that I want to highlight is the thing that you mentioned about eco waste management. It's also another brilliant project, Lampesh. I think we have the photo here of the eco waste management. I think you are turning like food waste into like fertilizers for farmers, right? Can you tell us more about this project?
Okay. I think now all the world have facing about the food waste problem, because it's rotten and so smell, and it's not good for the environment. Food waste is very, very big problem in the world. For the people, they don't have eco mindset and responsibility for the environment. Like think when you eat banana, you eat inside banana, but the peel, you will let it. And then you use more than 7 long. It's just like 1 month for decomposing. Is before decomposing is not good. But you imagine more of food like have a lot of smell. It's not good, right? And this project to make organic fertilizer is like we have farm very, very easy, and you can do it in your own country. I think all the many countries have this project already, but I'm sure this project to promote in Miss Earth, because this is very, very important, and we cannot ignore it, because the first we can join this project together. Let's start with your doing waste separate at your home. It's very important, because in my home I'm doing waste separate and then send the food waste. When คือเวลาที่รถขยะมาเก็บอะค่ะมันจะถูกไปเก็บที่เดียวกันแล้วในวิดีโอของเพชรมันจะมีสายพานที่จะแยก food waste กับขยะพลาสติกออกจากกันอันนี้ค่ะ food waste จะถูกไปทำเป็นปุ๋ยเป็น organic fertilizer แล้วก็ปุ๋ย organic ให้มีก่อนก็ได้
Alright, so when the garbage from my video, you see that when the garbage truck came to pick up the waste I prepare, and then you see that the food waste will be separated to prepare to make the fertilizer.
Yes. ปุ๋ยออร์แกนิกค่ะสุดท้ายแล้วมันดีกว่าปุ๋ยเคมีในเรื่องของการบำรุงดินเพราะว่ามันมีแร่ธาตุจากสารอาหาร
And also that I would like to highlight that organic fertilizer that came from the bio food waste is better, and it's way better than chemical fertilizer, because it has so much nutrition and it's good for earth.
ใช่ค่ะเพราะว่าตอนนี้นะคะ is my country is the country of farming, but the farming, you know what, is like very, very effect from the environment, because all the farmers use the chemical purpose to farming. But now I think we have to change to be the used organic purpose, organic fertilizer to do in farming. It's good for the earth and good for our health also, because we don't use any chemical in our food again. It's for sustainable resources, for the truly sustainable. Thank you.
Yes, you know what I noticed about what you are right now compared to last year is that you have a more defined idea of what you want to do as an advocacy. And I think those are really great advocacies. And I think that's what's going to like push you further into winning the crown, the very first crown for Thailand for Miss Earth 2020. So we cannot wait for that to happen if ever Nampech. Now one last question. Since you talked about plastic recycling and you talked about eco-waste management, what for you is the ultimate vision that you have? Since you are a really great environmentalist, what is the ultimate vision that you have for Mother Earth, personally, the ultimate vision that you have?
What is my big vision?
The dream, the ultimate dream that you have for Mother Earth.
I want all Mother Earth to be a cleaner and greener environment. I want all life to stay in the earth, have to peaceful and respect each other. This is my big goal. Is want to happen. I want all the human have to responsibility mindset to the another life in the earth. This is that's why I want to be Miss Earth 2020. It's not just I will take a crown and wear it on my head, but I will teach them to know about the benefit and why we have to take care of the Mother Earth. And I want to make a new trend and inspiring people to save environment and seeing the benefit, how we have the perfect environment to live. Because I'm predicted in 2015 will be more than the plastic waste in the ocean, more than marine life. And I don't want that happen. That's why I'm here today to join Miss Earth, to using Miss Earth Award to be her award to solving all the environmental problems in not even my country, but for all the Earth also. That's why I do a lot of projects to solving food waste, plastic waste, and also for now after the pandemic of COVID-19, we have a lot of problem about infection waste, about the face mask, about the possible gloves. And infection waste, of course, is cannot recycle them because it's infection. I want all of you to rethink about before you throw out the face mask, you cut the ear before you throw, because you never know when you throw a lot of plastic, you will have a lot of problem with another life, another animal, the little bird. Yeah, it's more important. For now, all world it didn't rest for the environment, like you guys understand, like COVID-19 come for make environment have a rest. Yes, we less pollution, we lessing all the ocean crisis, climate crisis. Yeah, but you know what? More the problem of the environment is the waste, about plastic waste and infection waste. We have to rethink about it and action for that, for reduce the plastic problem is more important. Thank you. Oh my God, I'm so excited when I answered the serious question. Now all my...
I know, yes. You know what, the best is as if you are already in the final, the grand coronation of Miss Earth 2020. You know what? If anyone from the organization is watching this, you have to crown her already. Crown Nampesh Teeyapar, Miss Earth Thailand, as your Miss Earth 2020. And we can't wait. It might happen on November 29. So now, before we move on to the very last part, allow me, Nampesh, to read some of the comments from the fans, because a lot of them are agreeing with us right now. John Mike, okay, I think Nampesh is just camera while we're doing that. John Mike Querido would like to say, where's the crown? Kindly put it to her head. She's amazing. John Mike says that to you, Nampesh. Maybe we can thank John Mike.
Thank you so much. Actually, I'm so excited. I am still playful girl and funny girl, but oh my God. But
I can feel it. Yes, definitely.
Some people are talking to me, but they want me to show my elegance, my gorgeous side. But this is me. This is 2020. I don't want to wear any face to the people. This is me. Sorry for some personality. I'm so naughty girl.
But that's what makes you a queen. So I'm totally happy that you're showing that very serious side about the environment. Thank you, Nampesh. Next one. Ruth Torres would like to say Thailand is blessed with a queen, an earth queen that is very dedicated and pure and genuine. Heart for the Mother Earth. Say hi to Ruth Torres.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much for your support. Captain Pat.
There you go, and maybe a couple more. You have here, if you have any questions, by the way, to the fans, if you have any questions to our queen, feel free to ask him right now. Jean-Claude DG would like to say, sending love and support to Queen Nampesh. Hashtag Miss Earth, hashtag Miss Earth 2020, hashtag Philippines.
Thank you so much. Hashtag Thailand also, please.
Thailand as well. And maybe a couple more. I've made a couple more here. We have here Starla Abalayan would like to say, I like her being prepared and resourceful. Starla Abalayan would like to mention that to you. There you go. Starla Abalayan would like to say hi to that. And maybe one last before we end and give you the floor to say your final message, Nampesh. There are a lot of comments here right now. I'd like to end with this one. Again from John Mike Querido. She's more than ready. She's more than ready. We love you from the Philippines. Nampesh, One last question. Are you ready to be the new Miss Earth 2020? How ready are you? Can you describe the feeling right now?
Thank you for your kind words. For like, I'm ready until my heart and my soul. I would like to say that. I'm very, very ready to make the world a better place. It's not just answer the question, I will do this, I will do that, but I'm already doing and start right now. Yeah, so if I become the Miss Earth 2020, for real, I will promise you guys, I will, oh, I'm so exciting. I will make the world a better place to reduce all the problem. We'll do a lot of my advocacy work with all the people around the world to stay on my earth. And it's not just speaking or saying like what you want all the judges to shoot me to be Miss Earth. Even I'm not win Miss Earth this year, this is my last chance and my last age to be to join the beauty queen. Even I'm not win the crown, I will still keep continuing for the Mother Earth. Thank you.
Nampech, since we have a lot of great conversations tonight, now is your time to say your special message to all of your supporters, maybe to your team, if you want to bring them out and say thank you to all of them. Now is your time. The floor is yours, Nampech. Say thank you to all of your supporters.
So I'm very, very thankful. Thank you for all of the kind words and positive words to give me a positive energy. You guys know English is not my language, but I will try my best to answer in English because the communication is very important, right? I am so thank you for having me tonight. Thank you for giving me a support. It's very, very important for my heart to do a good thing for the earth, for my life. And I cannot explain how appreciate I am right now because you know what? When we doing the competition or we in the pageant, it's so very, very tired. And I feel I didn't tired anymore because I enjoy all the time. I enjoy my life and I am very, very happy when you guys enjoy with me and cheers me to win the crown. And this is my last chance to join the beauty pageant. And I will doing my best to success on Miss Earth. Thank you so much.
One last message. Maybe you would like to say thank you to your team. I mean, it's 1 week from now we're going to crown the new Miss Earth 2020. Maybe you can say thank you to the team, to the virtual team that you have right now. I mean, maybe you can say hi and thank you to all of them, to your team right now. Yes.
Okay, I would love to say thank you in Thai language first because my team is Thai. Namhet yakka khokun tukukon naka ti support Pet. Khokun tukukon ti mi son luom nai kan support Miss Earth. ของเพชรไม่ว่าจะเป็นตั้งแต่ปี2019จนถึงปี2020คือตอนนี้ขอบคุณแม่คนแรกที่สู้ไปกับเพชรก็คือแม่เป้านะคะ I will cry if I say it ขอบคุณพี่มิ้งนะคะที่ทำชุดประจำชาติให้เพชรถึง2ปีซ้อนไม่ว่าแบบมันจะยังไงพี่มิ้งก็อยู่ข้างๆสปอร์ตเพชรพี่มิ้งกับพี่เป้าเป็นคนที่แบบเพชรอภิเชษมากๆเลยนะคะขอบคุณพี่ปกป้องนะคะที่เคียงข้างกันตลอดในเวลาที่เพชรอยู่ที่ฟิลิปปินส์หรือว่าอยู่ที่ไทยนะคะทุกๆอย่างขอบคุณสปอนเซอร์ทุกคนนะคะไม่ว่าจะเป็นฮิลันเซอร์เฟสขอบคุณพี่หมอกุ๊กไก่นะคะที่ ทำทุกอย่างให้หนูจริงๆแบบหนูไม่รู้จะขอบคุณยังไงสำหรับพี่หมอกุ๊กไก่นะคะทำให้หนูรู้สึกว่าหนูมั่นใจทุกครั้งที่หนูออกสื่อไปที่ไหนแล้วก็ขอบคุณทีมไทยแลนด์2019ทุกคนนะคะคุณพี่แหม่มแล้วก็ขอบคุณแม่น้องนะคะ National Director ปี2020แม่น้องเป็นคนที่ให้โอกาสเพชรที่ได้มายืนอยู่ตรงนี้นะคะขอบคุณทีมงานทุกท่านที่นั่งอยู่ในนี้เลยขอบคุณทุกๆคนที่ทำให้วันนี้มันเกิดขึ้นมันทำให้คนไทยแบบเห็นความสำคัญของเวที Miss Earth เห็นความสำคัญของสิ่งแวดล้อมจากการที่แบบทุกคนดูถูกเวที Miss Earth เพราะมันเป็นเวทีขยะเป็นเวทีที่ไม่สมศักดิ์ศรีเป็นเวทีแต่ว่าวันนี้เพชรหยุดแล้วว่าเวที Miss Earth เป็นเวทีที่มันคู่ควรจริงๆแล้วคนไทยควรซัพพอร์ตเพราะว่าเรายืนอยู่ในสิ่งแวดล้อมเราใช้สิ่งแวดล้อมร่วมกันอันนี้คือสิ่งที่เราต้องคอนเซิร์นอันนี้คือแพชชั่นของเพชรแล้วเพชรขอขอบคุณทุกอย่างขอบคุณแฟนนางงามทุกคนที่เชียร์เพชรขอบคุณวันนี้ขอบคุณทุกคะแนนที่ทุกคนกดโหวตให้เพชรไม่ว่าเพชรจะอะไรก็แล้วแต่ทุกคนเชียร์เพชรมากวันนี้เพชรขอบคุณจริงๆค่ะเพชรไม่สามารถร้องไห้ได้เดี๋ยวกลัวไม่สวยแต่ว่าขอบคุณจริงๆค่ะทุกคนขอบคุณค่ะ
They team ended. Yes, of course the team. Of course, yeah. Let's show the team. Sash Factor live chat viewers. I mean, we have spoken with. There you go. Oh, the team is so proud of you. Oh my God. There you go.
Oh my God.
This is such a tender moment. Yes. Yes. Maybe the rest of the team can like already show themselves already one by one.
Thank you.
Yes, of course. One last nampesh, since we are practicing here, I'd like to challenge you. Practice. I'd like you to like do your first walk ever as the new Miss Earth 2020. By introducing yourself, Nampesh Teeyapar, your new Miss Earth 2020. Ladies and gentlemen, Nampesh Teeyapar from Thailand. Let's do this.
Nampesh Teeyapar, Eco Angel of Thailand, your next Miss Earth 2020. Thank you.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, we have spoken with Miss Earth Thailand 2020, Nampesh Teeyapar, on behalf of the whole Sash Factor Live Chat Series team. Maraming salamat, Nampesh, for being here. Give her the crown right now. Love this. Super love this. Thank you so much, Nampesh. On behalf of the entire Sash Factor team, we are so happy to give you this opportunity. Maraming salamat for staying tuned. This has been your host, Noy Sabelano, saying stay safe. And let's all stay tuned to find out who's going to be the next Miss Earth 2020. Maraming salamat po sa ating lahat. Thank you so much, Nampesh Teeyapar from Thailand. Woo! Thank you.